been trying to do it right. Hey! I've been living a lonely life. Hey! I've been sleeping here instead. Hey! I've been sleeping in my bed. Hey! I've been sleeping in my bed. So show me family, hey! All the blood that I will bleed, hey! I don't know where I belong, hey! I don't know where I went wrong, hey! But I can write a song, hey! I belong to you, you belong to me, my sweetheart. I belong to you, you belong to me.
Lately I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the sink in the river, the lessons I learned. Take that money and watch it burn. Sink in the river, the lessons I learned. Take that money and watch it burn. Sink in the river, the lessons I learned. Take that money and watch it burn. Sink in the river, the lessons I learned.
Everything that kills me makes me feel alive.
Yeah, I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could be. Baby, I've been praying hard, said no more counting dollars, we'll be counting stars.
I don't normally come to formal things dressed quite so casually, but I've been asked to give this introduction in the last minute because Ian Baker, who's chair of Dublin Normal, was able to make it. It's great to see so many people here and to really celebrate the success of our young children at this presentation evening. I'm going to hand over to Jeff shortly. Just one thing, I think we're running a bit short of these, so if you do want one of these, if you can contact your son or daughter, and then we'll print some off on screen and get them back. But okay. Great, welcome again, and I'll hand over to Jeff.
Thanks very much for coming and attending the evening again. It's a very special part of the year for us. It's been another great year for A-level results in terms of the school. Pleasing that 23% of our grades were A or A star, with 41% A star to B, making those top grades that are so important to place at the university available for many students. Overall, we've got 96% pass rate A star to E, and 22 of our subjects came with 100% pass rate, which is one of the things that we really targeted over the course of this year. Over 11% of our students gained AAB or better in subjects that are called facilitating subjects. That's the government's latest new gold mark standard that we're supposed to get. And it's something that we're very proud of. It's a big leap forward for us. So very good. There are many stunning individual performances in that, which will be honoured tonight by Mr. Crook, so I'm not going to go on about that. But it's important for me that the students are prepared well for the next stage of their lives, and it's a very exciting time. It's also, I would think, of you like me, who's had a sun go through it, been a rather uncomfortable summer waiting for that envelope and all the news that it held. Most importantly, is that place at university, if that's what they're seeking, or that job that they wanted to go to, that hopefully that's been successful. And certainly from the conversations we've had, that's been the case for many of our students again this year. So thank you very much for all the hard work, particularly from the students themselves, but I do realise that comes on the back of a lot of hard work from staff and the support of you as parents in terms of helping to sort of motivate students and get on board with that horrible thing called revision. 2014 GCSE results contained many great achievements. 14% of our grades were AA star, 30% of students gained an English baccalaureate, which is a very special qualification there. Includes English, maths, science, humanities subjects, and one foreign language. For nearly a third of our students to get that is incredible. Average grade C across all of our exams, with 22 out of 26 subjects gaining A star C pass rates of 60%, and 8 subjects gaining above 80%. Unfortunately, I have to tell you that our GCSE results dipped significantly this year, and although we're appealing some of those results, what's disappointing for me is the fact that our English and literature results held up very highly. We got 70% pass rate in that. And maths was very strong again with a 70% pass rate. What it's done though for us, sadly, is to bring down our headline figure of 5% including English, 5% star C including English and maths, down to 48%. So we've never been in a position of to show how that's been achieved.
12% of students gained the final award of just the math, didn't get English, and so that would have boosted our figures in LN. In the same way, if we could include English literature, it would do the same thing as well. So it's a hard sort of message for us, really, and what it's meant is some significant changes in plans for English over the next 12 months that we must get right to make sure that we've got the necessary resources that we want in 2015. There have been many, many exceptional performances from students, and it was nice to see so many happy faces on that dreaded day in August, and as you'll see tonight, many of those being honoured for their performances as well. In terms of the wider picture, there have been some great growth in many, many areas. PE, for example, you see more teams, more participants, more trophies being won, more high-level representation than ever before, including national champions, and it's great to see Matthew Williams do so well in terms of his chosen sport. Looking forward to a trip away. I'd like to sanction you going to put some more on. What I haven't been able to sanction is all the stuff you wanted to go and carry with bags. So that's been fantastic, and to mark that, because it's been such a special year, with the support of the Friends of William Wood School, we've gone through and we're looking at putting up a new display down the corridors around the Leisure Centre of some really fantastic pictures. And so next time in the Leisure Centre, please look out for those bits of work Paul Bertram has put together for us. Many of you may well have attended the annual sports awards evening, which has become such a fantastic evening. I'm starting to worry whether we can compete with it as a presentation evening. It's fantastically supported. The team down in PE have done a great job, particularly that night, was the sort of idea and the concept and a lot of hard work put together by Ian Hennessy. So, unfortunately not with us tonight, but I did want to recognise his part in that fantastic work. Performing arts, the range of shows and events that's happened this year again has been fantastic. Dance, drama, music, showcase the talents of our young students. I particularly admire that ability to be able to stand on the stage at the age of somewhere between 11 and 18 and actually produce a performance in front of the whole gathering that I just think most people of that age reflect yourself is something that I assume can never be able to do. The shows and classes that mix primary and secondary together are really important part of our transition process and also part of building our students' ability to become good young leaders and good citizens in terms of the way that they work with the issue. So all of those things have drawn fantastic audiences into the school for those school events. What has been pleasing though is the way that things have developed for me anyway in the Arts Centre. Who would ever believe Alan Carr and Lee Evans would have had the pleasure of standing in my place here entertaining people slightly less than I'm doing at the moment. But it is fantastic that 250 people can watch someone of that quality in such a friendly place. And that's only part of the story when you think of the growth of National Theatre Live, the opera, the ballet, the fact you can come and watch the ballet that's taking place in the Met in America. And see it in a place like this, I think, is wonderful, and where technology truly is doing the job that it should be doing. So we're forging new friends, getting new people into this building, and that only comes on the back of a lot of hard work and effort, and I do personally thank both the Performing Arts and the Edge staff for their work in that area. Extracurricular clubs across the school have grown massively too. It's wonderful when you stay late at the site to see literally hundreds and tens of hundreds of students leaving the place who've stayed behind after hours doing the various clubs that they've put on. Keeping them active, keeping them happy, and hopefully in many ways keeping them healthy as well. We have liaisons with the Rotary Club as well, and that's allowed us to offer other things that we've never done before, things like public speaking, a cookery competition, and that rider, a young leader award course that's gone out of the BAM course this summer for a week. Developing the leadership skills in two students from sixth form who have that opportunity to go through, and that will be a fantastic thing on their CV. That adds to the offer that we've always had of the Duke of Edinburgh, and trips that have ranged from a trip taking the year 7 students around our catchment area for those who have the heights of ski slopes in Italy. All those things are about developing the machines. It's not necessarily about spending lots of money, it's about providing opportunities that they don't necessarily have got anywhere. I do believe this school is a fantastic school full of caring people, and I do think that includes our wonderful students as well. And particularly, I'd like to thank you as supportive parents, you know, here again tonight, giving you time. As I often see, that car park full of students, you know, having that inability to walk 10 yards down the road, as they do. But it is, without your support, none of these things could happen. And we do genuinely really appreciate it. And that builds on the word then, that my staff give you to their tireless time and the use that they get of this fantastic. I would like to thank a very special group of parents that have supported us above and beyond this year again. That's the Friends of William Brooks School, who raised thousands of pounds for the school. They're very clear about the fact it has to be spent in the right way. It's not a case of just giving out money. They're very clear about making us make bids for things that otherwise the school would not have been able to provide you with things again. So that's provided opportunities for fantastic things to happen, including lots of extra benches and seating outside on the fields, and sometimes the students don't appreciate those things, but I certainly do. And when I walk around the school, there are many things that you know that are attributable to that group of people. Particularly though, Ms. Rolfall, Helen and Andrew and Bonsby are stepping down from their posts of responsibility, and they've certainly been people who played a huge role in just taking that cause of the Friends of the New York and taking it on to a new level that we never identified. So I do thank them. Finally, I'd like to a big thank you in preparation for that, I guess, to Tom Davis, who's come to join us tonight. Tom is a fantastic role model, and I'm sure from what you hear tonight you realise about how inspiration is to our students. He'll entertain you and inspire you in a way that all athletes have an ability to do, because I think that's what their life is based upon, the ability to be able to really sort of put themselves into a very special position. He's a modest and reserved guy, some say. I've never seen that side. But he is, I have to say, a true gentleman. I feel really honoured that someone who's committed to sport at the level that he has is willing to come in and work with you inside our school. So, I do want you to enjoy the night. I hope it doesn't get too hot in here. But best wishes to all the students who brought awards to that classic 2014. On your achievements today, but also most importantly, on that next step of the journey that you're on, particularly those who are in 13 and going off to various places around the country. Be proud of what you've achieved. Make the most of the opportunities that are there, because they come at an expensive cost now. Don't waste that opportunity. And yet, do make sure that you work hard and play hard. So, thank you very much for me. And what I'd like to do is to introduce the next act, which is Vincent Dance. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's my pleasure to introduce the ECHP Awards. Now, these awards are about houses, and there are three categories of this award: effort, progress, and solidarity. Effort is for students who have achieved the most or the highest effort grades in that year. Progress is the most academic progress in that year. And attainment is the absolute highest level. So, without further ado, the Athens winners are for efforts in year 7, Katie Evans. Imogen the Waters in their year 8 exactly.
Nine, Charlie Collins wins the Progress Award for Culture.
unfortunately he's not in this. So moving on to the Attainment Awards in year 7, the award goes to Ami Bani. And in year 8, Jodie Bain. Finally, in year 9, we have the winner of the Olympians Overall Achievement Award going to Charlie Shearer.
Okay, it gives me great pleasure to announce some of the awards. So, starting with effort in year 7 is Paris
material she's read, and she considers issues carefully and gives thoughtful opinions about the demanding topics in which she wishes to talk about. Ms. Hurton said she's worked in the library and helped in the day-to-day management in that area. She was on the Carnegie Reading Group and helped to vote for the best book in the past 12 months. That's 8 books on the list, and you take 1 book every week, and that book's about this big. You don't have to give it right to review from you. And was also in the Bashers winning team, which was a competition that we take part in linked against its school. She's a lovely young lady, she's a fantastic leader, far beyond her age in terms of the maturity of the material that she reads. Trophy is a trophy that's awarded every year. It's a very special trophy, and the fact that it's awarded in remembrance of a student who used to be at the school, unfortunately, died sadly on our school playing field in June 1998, aged just 14. It rocked the school community, but what's been nice to come out of it is that this award celebrates both her love of rounders and her love of life. The recipient of the year this year is our bowler, and our captain of the rounders, Jenny. The last award is the Vision of Flyers Award, and I'm asked Tom Brown to come to the
Good evening, everybody. I'm happy to present the Vision of Flyers Award, which goes to young people who have shown outstanding leadership and service to the community. This year there's a particular young man who's whose works for charity are too numerous to mention, but his particular star achievement was to lead the 77-mile walk of primary school children from here to the sea. And I'd like to introduce Alan Goodman, if he'd come forward.
Insoluble problem. Major crisis. Both stepmothers want their names on the wedding invitation. Catherine adores her stepmother, who more or less brought her up. She wants her name to appear on the wedding invitation. Whereas my stepmother, whom I detest, is now questioning her name should appear on the wedding invitation. But my father won't have this without hers. There's Catherine's stepmother's left off, which is completely unacceptable. I suggest none of the parents' names should be on the invitation. After all, we're not adolescents. We can arrange our own wedding by people ourselves. But Catherine screams at her, saying it would be a slap in the face to her parents. Especially her stepmother, who's been so nice by everything, when it isn't even her daughter. So I allow myself to be persuaded completely against my better judgment because she wore me down. Not the side that my stepmother, whom I detest, is a big cow, has to have her name on the wedding. So I call my mother to warn her. I say, Mother, I've done everything I can to avoid this, but Yvonne's name has to be on the wedding invitation. Hey, my half! Calm down, don't make things more difficult. Everything's been cooked up behind my back. Mother, I have friends waiting. There's always something better to do. Anything's more important than me. Goodbye! Catherine, who hadn't heard her side of the conversation, came in and said, what did she say? Said she just wanted a name on the wedding invitation next to a bond, which is understandable. No, no. What did she say about the wedding? Nothing. Your name! I'm not lying, Catherine. She just doesn't want a name on the wedding invitation. You call her back. You call her back and tell her when her son gets married, you rise above your vanity. So I call her, but by now, I'm in shreds. Mother, I say, why are you so selfish? I'm not selfish, Ivan. You're the one who's got to learn about life. Go on. Don't spare your precious friends. And then nothing. Nothing's been sorted. I hang up.
To introduce the Key Stage 4 Awards. The first award is the Award for Dance, which goes to Kerri-Anne Hewlett. Kerri-Anne worked constantly at an excellent level in terms of her technical skills.
Speech!
Okay. Kerri-Anne worked consistently to an excellent level in terms of her technical skill and the effort and commitment to the subject. Her choreography was imaginative and original in its ideas and performed with musical precision. She dedicated a significant amount of time to her students, offering the technical skills for performance to ensure that they were able to achieve the best of ways possible. So the award for that drama goes to Amber Jones. Amber has been a fantastic drama student, who, like many others, worked tirelessly and cares greatly about the subject. Ultimately, she received a rare A-star grade overall. Amber gets this award for giving so much of her free time to support lessons lower down the school. She volunteered to do work experience with us, and then carried this on in her free time, making a difference to experience for many students. The award for French goes to Kirsten Jones. Kirsten has always shown herself to be a motivated language learner with really high standards. She shows natural ability in French, where she performed extremely well in all skill areas of GCSE, and achieving an impressive A star overall. We are delighted to be continuing with French today. The award for German goes to Matthew Hartup. Matthew is a gifted linguist who has been a real asset to the language department. He has an amazing memory and a fantastic understanding of the rules of language, and is able to apply all of his knowledge to produce outstanding work in all four skill areas. I know he's keen to continue his study of languages in the future, and we feel very proud that we've inspired him to do this. We wish him every success in the future and hope that he will come back and share his love of language with our younger students in the future. The award for music goes to Emily Wilson. Emily listened to all the advice she was given and then worked really hard to produce two excellent performances and two very well constructed and imaginative compositions. You've been a pleasure to work with both within the classroom and as a member of the musical orchestra. Best wishes for the future. The Wenlock Olympians Award for contribution to PE goes to Amelia West. Amelia is a warrior. She is one of the bravest students Mr. Hennessy has come across because she's so good to see. A few of the boys are even scared of her. Over the past 3 years, she has progressed from a school hockey player to a top county player. Amelia has been committed to a school club in county hockey and has the potential to move into regional hockey by the end of the year. Amelia is a tough cookie who will never let her school down, whether it's in volleyball, badminton, cross country, football, hockey, or even athletics. Not only does she represent the school to the highest level as a performer in many sports, she's also a fantastic leader who gives her time to provide sporting opportunities for others. She's a key leader in the running of the winter and the summer school games, which brings the best students to represent their areas in sport from the country and county. Amelia is a fantastic role model for our younger students. She's taken advantage of the fantastic opportunities at the school and understands the importance of being part of the team. Unfortunately, she's not here. So the Wenlock Olympians Award for PE goes to Matthew Griffiths. Matthew's been competing in biathlon for a few years now. In fact, he's competed at the British School Championships 3 times. Matthew's strength has always been his swimming, where he trains and competes regularly for the North Face Swimming Club. The running discipline was always something he just did, like, with minimal training. He was good enough to make the school cross-country team and athletics team, so he didn't really need to train until last year. Last year, Matthew qualified for the British School's Modern Biathlon Championship. This year, and he realised that to stand on the podium he's going to have to do some running training. So he did. Matthew managed to fit in 4 running sessions alongside his swimming sessions every week. He's a quietly determined young man, and for 3 months he worked incredibly hard. At the Olympic Park, on Sunday the 6th of April, all his hard work paid off. He swam around the fastest than he'd ever done before, and we are very proud to say that Matthew Griffiths is the under-16 Boys British Biathlon Champion 2014. Over the summer, Matthew was invited to go to the West Midland Triathlon Academy for a training camp in France. Following winning the National Biathlon Championship, he's now been selected to go to Guatemala as a member of the British team for the World Biathlon Championship. Cubitan Award for 2014 goes to Alice Spittle-Jackson. Alice has been a tremendous asset to the school. Not only was she a key driver of the school newsletter, but has also been a key Stage 4 representative on the school council. She's a person who strongly believes in fairness and taking the side of the underdog. In her own life, her medical condition means that she can get exhausted incredibly quickly. This has placed huge barriers at times, like revising for exams and on really busy days. Most people would use this as an excuse for an easier life, But Alice has been so determined to do her best that she's worked through these barriers and tiredness that many others can only imagine. And one of my friends has the same condition as Alice, and I know it absolutely destroys you. It takes so much out of you, so the work between Alice and others has been incredible. This year, all that hard effort's paid off, where she got 11 GCSEs, 4 A's, 7 B's, and this is the mentality that has earned her Hopkins Medal. The Derek Hill Outstanding Contribution to the School Award goes to Sophia Goldsby. Sophia is one of the kindest and most pleasant young individuals you could happen to meet. She has freely given her time to help out at all school events. She is an outstanding house captain for Athens and represented the school to the best of her ability on numerous occasions. Mr. Wilson said she was super reliable. Academically, she's one of our highest achieving students last year, gaining 11 A stars and A's. Following a conversation with her last week, she's now set her sights on going to RSC. I think if she continues with the same vein, the same determination, dedication, still lower down the school, I think you've got every chance of success. Well done. Achieved the RS Award.
obviously a pleasure to teach. She clearly loved the thought-provoking and controversial issues we put at GCSE, always willing to share her opinions to the rest of the class. She worked consistently hard and always did her best. She completed language revision booklets designed by the department, all 8 of them to a top standard, and achieved a grade A at GCSE. Absolutely, she should be really proud of her achievements.
Sam is a wonderful and hard-working student, not not only contempt for getting a grade A in his GCSE ICT, but also a distinction in his ICT Nationals qualification at level 2. These qualifications together show that Sam has a range of computing skills, from producing formulas to big spreadsheets, producing interactive websites and presentations using a variety of elements and alternative pathways to navigate. Very good to see you doing ICT. Good luck. We've got the 14 to 16 vocational award for Lewis Dyer. In the middle of this. Lewis is a hard-working and dedicated student who studied mechanics at Ipswich School once a week. He put all of his efforts into his course and into his school life. He was always smiling and joined in with many activities to offer to him. We wish him all the very best on his apprenticeship course. Mathematics goes to Ben Jones. Ben has always demonstrated a natural aptitude for mathematics. This, together with his ability to work independently, has led to this fantastic fusion of an A star in his GCSE, and also cementing foundations for his A-level. He was chosen to study mathematics at A-level, and have persuaded him to do AS further maths alongside his own form, just to keep him. The award goes for achieving one of the best set of exam results that summer. She achieved 5 A stars, 3 A's, 2 B's, and a distinction in ICT, which is fantastic. And she decided to come back for another 2 years to study A levels. We wish you all the best. Events we have held at the school. He's delivered flyers in the local community by advertising our events, helping out with cake sales for children in need, helping with the supervision of the library at lunchtimes. A couple of years ago, he applied through the J.L. Edwards scheme to take his dad to London to see the Fire Museum in Westminster Abbey. He gave a mature speech to a committee and was awarded the funds. So thank you, Sam, for all of your help.
First of those is Holly Arden, who's won the Stage 4 Biology Prize. And Mrs. Bennett wrote about Holly that she seemed to work harder in every biology lesson she attended. She was one of the most determined pupils that Mrs. Bennett's ever met, working methodically to ensure that no part of the course was not learned. Revised, reviewed, and tested, Holly completed her coursework with the same determination, achieving one of the top marks in the year. She's always had a kind and caring personality, taking time to support pupils in her class, ensuring that they also understood and could succeed. It's been an absolute pleasure to teach. And she was our house captain and has set a real high bench for that for the house captains this year. And we wish her every success in the future. Thank you. Second prize is the Stage 4 Chemistry Prize, and that is going to Mary Dodd. Molly's a first-rate chemist. As we neared the end of year 11, she realised that she actually got most of the content we were studying. And it seemed to take her a bit by surprise. She was a careful, methodical student who asked thoughtful questions and then applied her knowledge. Molly worked well independently and developed superb study skills. The result? An excellent, well-deserved GCSE. Molly, so very well done, and we're so glad to have you. The next award is for citizenship, and that goes to Jasmine Clark. in her absence. Mrs. Turner has written about Jasmine, that she's always been a lovely as well as a very self-motivated student throughout the course. She worked quietly and determinedly to produce work that was always consistently excellent in quality. It wasn't an easy 2 years for Jasmine, and she deserves her A-star grade, which is 2 grades above her predicted grade. We hope that she will have a great future, and we wish her every happiness and success. The next prize is the Key Stage 4 Geography Prize, and that goes to Ellie Burnham, and unfortunately she can't be with us this evening. Ellie was awarded an A-star overall, and she did this by scoring 231 out of 240 marks on her exam. She only dropped 9 marks. She managed to get 60 out of 60 for one part of the exam, an outstanding effort. She's a very independent student, we know that, who showed initiative in her control assessment and devised a very effective revision strategy for her numerous case studies. We wish her every good luck in the future. But Mr. Thomas does say she should have done that. Our next prize winner is Isabel Cook, and she's winning the Key Stage 4 Physics Prize. And physics teachers have written about Isabel that she responded very positively to the intellectual demands of the physics course. She persevered with the course, working exceptionally hard, both in class and independently, and has shown much dedication. She's got a conscientious approach to problem solving, and she won't leave anything to chance. She always makes sure she knows what everything means and what she's doing, and that has resulted in her excellent results in physics. Applied Science Award, and this goes to Leah Venables, a truly outstanding student in this course. Leah was determined, and she pushed and pushed throughout the 2 years of the course. When she really got her sights set on nursing, there was no stopping her. Because that's what your aim was, isn't it, Leah? She made sure that every lesson her work was at the high standard, and as her teacher, she wanted my work to be at the high standard as well. So she made sure that she got the challenge that she needed, and she acted on the feedback given to her by the teachers who worked with her, not just me, but some of the teachers too. She worked steadily towards the exam, and those efforts were really the great thing we were for. And I was here on results day, and I know that her results are more for that, so I'm going to make lots of results. So well done. Teachers wrote to her, she was a pleasure to teach, she always showed an interest in lessons, and that rubbed off on everyone she worked with, even the toughest of characters, with charm there. An all-round lovely young lady who worked incredibly hard, highly motivated, well organised, asks really good questions and has a dedication to succeed, and you've got characteristics. Outstanding achievements. The first of those is for a student named Anna Brancombe. Unfortunately, Anna had a family who moved to London since the results, so in a moment Kerri-Anne Hewitt will come and collect her award for her. We've heard of lots of students who've got outstanding progress awards and outstanding achievement. Anna was the top performing student in which she achieved 16 grades higher than her predicted grades across all her subjects. And it was truly outstanding. And anybody who knew Anna will know that she was a determined student, she was always happy and cheerful and trying her best in everything that she did. And it's a real shame that she's not here to hear her congratulations on her success. But I'm sure we'll pass them on to her now. Brett Law as well. winning the prize for outstanding progress. And Ms. Tutor and Ms. Ravenscroft have given me some information about Brett, and I do know that as well. And they said that when he first joined the school, he found it hard to be independent and just to express his own opinions. And his learning journey has not been an easy one, but he's always listened to advice. And Mrs. Ravenscroft thinks that he represents the true Olympian ideal of personal best, that she always felt that you were doing your personal best. And that he knows that this learning journey is a marathon, not a sprint. And that over the last 5 years, you've changed significantly. And the tutor particularly recognises that, because by the time you were in year 11, you were a real role model to the young students in the tutor group, and they looked up to you. And that's why he's won the prize for outstanding. So well done. Lucy Harper and Barnaby Aswell, the talented musicians who are going to perform a piece of music called Who's Heard.
I'm
The next prize is the English Literature Prize, and this goes to Lauren Williams. Lauren always demonstrated complete commitment to doing the very best she can, always working, sometimes too much. Ever modest, Lauren always handed in work with an apology and an exception that it was bad. Marking always revealed, however, that your fears were entirely groundless. Though Lauren is a very intelligent young woman, success came to her through a huge amount of work. She would apologise for giving her teachers more essays to mark, but Lauren is one of those students for whom time is a given. We can always make time for people who deserve it. The next prize is for further maths, and this goes to Kenna Pujara. Kenna has been a delight to have as a member of our department. This might sound strange to you, but she was part of the fixtures and fittings of the maths department. She was a valuable mentor to our younger students, tutored our year 11s, along with studying A-level maths and further maths today. She deserved her A star at A-level maths and a B grade at further maths due to the time she spent with Mr. Westcott and Mrs. Caldwell, ensuring she understood all the aspects of the course. Well done, Kenna, and we wish you the very best for you. The next prize is the Geography Prize, and this goes to Michael Andrews. Michael managed to get a B grade overall at ATE. He did particularly well in Module 3, where he got an A grade on a very demanding paper. He has been great to teach, he has a wicked sense of humour, helped me with IT, and been keen to help others. He also knows the way to gain favour with a teacher. He helped design and make a world cake with flanks for Mr. Thomas's birthday. It was very impressive. Mr. Thomas looks bad all the time. I wish you every best, very best for the future. The next award is the History Prize, and this goes to Poppy Williams. Poppy's teacher said that she was one of the highest achievers in history at this level, consistently performing at A-grade standard. Her individual study on the Spanish Civil War was well-researched and informatively written, and achieved the equivalent of an A-star. She had an ideal attitude towards study and has built a firm foundation for her future. The next prize is the ICT Prize, and this has been given to Rupert Crane. Rupert can't be with us this evening. Rupert remained a very diligent and enthusiastic student, despite many hurdles along his way. He was very proactive in seeking help with all aspects of his work, and used the exam board criteria and feedback from his teachers constructively in order to complete tasks. Rupert produced a very good interactive website, as well as developing many new computer and personal skills in planning projects. Good luck in your future, Rupert. You definitely deserve the ICT. The next prize is the Maths Prize, and this goes to Ed Tyler. Ed has been a pleasure to teach, and has worked extremely hard to achieve an A star in A-level Maths, and an A at AS Further Maths. When he told us in January of Year 12 that he had made a mistake not taking Further Maths, we did our best to accommodate this alongside all his other A-level subjects. Ed has taught himself most of the course, given up free time to get advice, and has worked independently for the whole 2 years. We wish you well in the future. The next prize is the Modern Foreign Languages Prize, and this goes to Alice Cotton, again, unfortunately can't be with us tonight. Alice thoroughly deserves this award. She has always shown herself to be a most determined student who only ever satisfies herself with the very best. What is particularly impressive is the fact she managed to combine her studies so well with training regularly at archery at national level, and achieved top grades across the board. She has been a real asset to the Languages Department, regularly supporting French lessons to assist younger students with their French. In fact, she even came into school for 3 days at the start of this term to work with classes, and she wanted to brush up on her French before going off to Birmingham Uni, where she studied French and Spanish. She's been an excellent student, and we wish her all the best. And the next prize is the PE Prize, and unfortunately Josh Burrows can't be with us this evening.
Josh was an excellent physical education student who excelled on the field and in the classroom. He was an outstanding sports leader who could always be relied upon to complete any task effectively and shared his enthusiasm and passion for sport with others. Josh had a stellar sporting career at William Brooks in cross country and middle distance track running. He has represented the school, county and Midlands many times and has competed in the English school championships, with his highest position being 9th. In the classroom, Josh applied the same dedication to his studies and he displayed in his sporting career. He would always complete tasks on time and showed a real thirst for knowledge. He would drive the class forward, helping others and contributing to lessons. He has chosen to continue his sporting ambitions by applying to the RAF PT instructor, to be a RAF PT instructor. And Josh has recently completed his 3-day physical fitness assessment, passing with flying colours. We wish him every success with his chosen career, and we'll be watching closely to see him on our television screens representing Great Britain on the track. The next prize is for physics, and this goes to Timothy Resch. Tim has been outstanding in A-level physics from the beginning of his life, and on various occasions has demonstrated effective completion of tasks to a high standard through his independent learning skills in class. His practical and analytical skills have been exceptionally good, and he shared a good working relationship with his peers, facilitating him to achieve an A grade in his year 13. The next prize is the Government of Politics Prize, and this goes to Dan Corker, who can't be with us this evening. Dan was among the top performing students in Government of Politics, showing a sound understanding of modern global issues and political institutions. He was always eager to learn and pushed himself to succeed in what was a new subject in the GCE level. Well done. The next prize is the Product Design Prize, and this goes to Josh McWaters. There were many occasions during his 2-year course where Josh confronted obstacles with his progress, but he managed to overcome them to produce a successful design project. And Josh has always been a natural graphic designer and artist, often displaying great flair. The design contributes to every success for his Josh. The next prize is the Psychology Prize, and this goes to Pippa Kerman. Pippa was the still waters who run deep in our group. She hated speaking out in class, but her work was always exceptional. You can guarantee that without fail, Pippa will be the first to ask me to check her drafts and will be the first to hand the finished product in. She has a reflective approach to her own learning and is able to evaluate her own strengths and weaknesses. She is an effective communicator, able to formulate a coherent argument for an essay. Pippa is that unusual individual who combines a logical, scientific nature with tons of creativity. I'm jealous of the university where she will attend as a student, for I shall miss her greatly. The next prize is for religious studies, and this goes to Isla Reese. Mrs. Watkins says, both myself and Mr. Pugh have thoroughly enjoyed having such an opinionated and passionate student studying philosophy and ethics. She continued to impress us throughout the year, especially with her contributions to discussions. Isla says it how it is and knows how to argue, making her a perfect student to debate and evaluate philosophical issues and ethical dilemmas. Isla, who at times dreaded those endless essays and one-page summary sheets, she always did apply herself, worked hard, and through sheer determination achieved her target grade of a B. A well-deserved prize, Isla. Well done. The next award is the Theatre Studies Prize, and this goes to Kate Entwistle, who can't be with us this evening. Kate is such a committed drama student. She works hard and then always questions what more she could do. Kate has always been a great ambassador for drama within the school, through her involvement in various productions and even starting and running a French-speaking drama club for some Year 7 students to perform in the end of the year celebration assemblies. We would like to thank her for everything she has done and wish her all the best. The next award is the Wenlock Players Trophy, and this year it goes to Ellie Ward. The winner of this award has shown a real commitment to the performing arts over the years of Liam Brooks, through her excellent performances in productions such as Bugsy Malone, Grease, and as makeup artist for Return of the Forbidden Planet. But this award is primarily for the amazing amount of time, enthusiasm, and skill that her and her co-writer and director gave to last year's Six White Pantomime. The co-director George Robinson will receive an award later on, but for you, Ellie, you've taken on the task of writing, planning and directing any production. It is always a huge undertaking, but particularly with your own peers. A testament to this huge contribution is the great success of the Panto and all shows she has been involved in. Thank you for all you have done with the department over the years. I'm now going to move on to the Progress Awards and Academic Achievement Awards. The first Progress Award is for personal progress, and it goes to Dan Burton, who can't be with us. He's already in Edinburgh, getting ready for his British university life. I remember back to when Dan was finishing his GCSEs, and I had this conversation with him many times over the last 2 years, about whether A-levels were the right route for him. We had a lot of coming and going between us, and I'm really pleased that he decided to give it a go, and there has never been a question since he started that it was the right path. We've never had to speak once about poor performance or any issues. He just got his head down and got on. He went from being a laid-back, bit of a lad, to a mature, well-mannered, hard-working young man who has done himself and us very proud. He's the perfect example to young people of what growing up is all about, and I and the other staff who knew him well wish him all the best. The next Progress Award goes to Elliot Blencaron, who again can't be with us unfortunately this evening. Elliot has really matured over his time in the Sixth Form and realised that sometimes you have to stop and listen to the advice given in order to achieve your best. He has always been academic since arriving at William Brooks in Year 12, but it's the way that he has changed in his approach to his studies and developed as a person that makes him stand out. He was quite shy and reserved in the beginning, and has steadily changed into an integral part of any class, always willing to contribute and have his say. Well done for all the progress you've made, Elliot. Congratulations. The next Progress in Sixth Form Award goes to Jessica Nichols. Jess has made superb progress over the course of her A-levels and has fought tirelessly to overcome the challenges and stumbling blocks in her way. There are many times when Jess could have given up and thrown in the towel, and it's fair to say the road has been difficult. But Jess, unlike a lot of other students who might be faced with the same challenges, carried on, worked hard and used her teachers and family support to get through. I'm so pleased with the results you've achieved, and I know that you've earned every single mark on those result sheets through sheer hard work and determination. All the best for you, Jess. The next prize is for outstanding achievements, and it goes to Sophie Shires. Sophie fully deserves this award. She has worked tirelessly to achieve the results that she has over the last 2 years. She is so conscientious and always tries to go over and above the normal expectations. Her A's results were superb, but to then achieve 2 A stars in an A shows the consistency and talent she has, especially when you encounter a few setbacks along the way. You're a superb student and you will reach the goals that you've set yourself. It's great that you've already found your way back into school to help support science lessons this term, and you'll be really missed. All the best. The The next student has achieved two awards tonight. First of all, the Law Prize, and secondly, the Award for Outstanding Achievement. And it goes to Claire York. Not many students achieve 5 A-levels. Not many students get A's and A stars. And if students get close to that, then they've done exceptionally well. So for Claire to have achieved 3 A stars and 2 A-levels, it's truly outstanding. Claire is an ideal student. Hard-working, motivated, but not afraid to get stuck in and have her say. I've had many wonderful conversations with her that show the level of maturity she has at such a young age. Her teachers cannot praise her enough. To get full marks in assessments is all anyone can ask for. I'm so impressed by the way Claire has approached her time here. Never happy to just do okay, always striving for perfection, but still understanding that it can take time. All I can say is you've set the bar very high for future students, and you'll be great in it. All the best. The final award for the sixth form is the Charlotte Haynes Award, and this goes to George Robinson. This is an award that we give out every year in memory of Charlotte, who died shortly after attending William Brooks' sixth form. She was somebody who always got involved in everything the school had to offer, never wanted to shirk away from anything, got stuck in and really enjoyed sixth form life. And George Robinson emulates the passion and that student. This award, George was a key student throughout his time in year 7 to 11, but more recently has made a significant contribution as the vice president and then the president of the sixth form, which involved talking at key events and being the face of the sixth form. His charming personality made him liked by all and helped him get people engaged and involved in all the events and fundraising that's taking place. His role in the organisation of the sixth form Pants Over Delhi was something that significantly stands out. It took a lot of hard work and time, especially when you're dealing with the many divas involved in a Pants Over. But George was never one to complain, never one to shirk away from a challenge, and always, always helped me out when I was in a sticky situation with trying to get students involved. Not only has George contributed significantly to the sixth form in school, but he's achieved an outstanding set of A-level results with A's and B's at the same time. Thank you personally for all the help you've given me, and I wish you all the best. I'd like to hand over to Tom Davis for the main.
Evening everyone. I genuinely love being invited to award evenings like this to help celebrate the success of young people in general. I probably wasn't the best student, so it's really good to make up for it. What I missed out as a youngster coming to these tonight. My background is judo. Unfortunately, in the programme it says wrestling, easily confused. Some people say I cuddle people for a living. I assure them I do it as hard as I can to make up for that slight embarrassment. I was never the greatest junior judo player. And with that said, I actually stopped and moved away from my area. And it wasn't until at 16, so similar ages to some of these in the audience. And I went back to my judo club, and I was the type of person just to say hello. But I didn't really want to get involved in the possibility of getting thrown around, and that doesn't excite me. I don't know about you, but I didn't want to be thrown around. But I went back to the judo club and I was looking through the window, saying hello to my friends, you know, being that chief champion on the outside, also known as annoying. And the coach caught my eye, and he walked towards the door and he poked his head out and he just asked me one question. He said, "Are you training?" And I looked at him like he was crazy. He said, "No." I think I might have even said, "Hell no." And he just frowned at me, and he was this charismatic guy. And as he frowned at me, I suddenly went confused, and a little wide smile came across his face, and I started going like that, because he was getting the appropriate response and the appropriate smile. And I walked in, not knowing what to expect, and he gave me a kick, and I got changed. And the reason I didn't want to train, I was a bit scared, I can admit that, and I didn't want to get thrown. I'd be lying if I said I didn't. I did a lot. And I remembered why I liked it. Every time I got thrown, I got to try and throw them back. And I remember that very first day, you know, looking on the wall, and there was three pictures on the wall. Now, these were three kids that I had taken to judo as a private school student. I said, come try judo, see what it's like. And to get your picture of my judo clubs, all you had to achieve one of three things: a national medal, represent Great Britain, or you had to get your black belt. And I walked in that day and I thought, that is amazing. And I thought, what was the difference between them going on to something that I would be considering really good? One had a black belt, one had a national medal, and one had been to a thing called the Youth Olympics. And the difference was they had stayed on, they had worked hard, and they had dedicated themselves to be the best that they could be in judo. And I thought to myself, I'd like some of that. And I was inspired by those around me to, I suppose, want a little bit more. It was probably one of the first times in my life that I actually wanted to do something in sport, but I really wanted to do something. And so, set about training, I made a little plan, and a year and a half later, I got to the Nationals. I cut a long story short, I got a lovely, lovely medal. In the right life, I can tell you it's a goal. And we all know it was a little cheeky rub. More importantly, with that medal, I, like my friends, got my picture on the wall. Now, you can do this any age from 12 upwards. So the only slide brought back by this time, I was probably 18. And there's a little 12-year-old next to me and a 13-year-old on the other side. But I'm a great believer in better late than never. And I look back at that moment, and really and truly, it was about a choice. I suppose I chose to do something different, and I took a bit of personal responsibility to actually dedicate myself to do something, which is what I assume everybody receiving awards tonight has done. Because you don't get to receive these awards without putting yourself out there and doing something that you wouldn't have normally done in years gone by. You've made that choice. So I suppose work hard, and like they said, dedicate yourselves to do a little bit better, a little bit better. It reminded me of a time when I was actually at primary school. I don't know if you won't know this now. You won't believe it. But they actually decided to put me back in it. You know, and that was a really, really hard thing for a 9-year-old to take, you know. I was told, for me, I saw that as a massive, massive stigma, you know. He's not quite bright enough, so he's going his normal year. And it was the only other time in my life where I remembered actually dedicating myself to something quite in the same manner, because I wanted to prove them wrong. And you know, with that goal and with that kind of vision, I managed to work hard, and by the end of the year, I wasn't quite there, but it's important to go back to your normal year. And I was like, that was amazing. And it just shows what you can do with, I suppose, having that goal. I'm sorry to do this, but Leah, is it Miss Lacey mentioned that as soon as she realised she wanted to be a nurse, you know, she set her sights on getting that goal science award. And it's amazing once you have that vision how hard you will work to get what you want. And I think back now to being fortunate enough to compete for GB for at least 10 years. And travelled the world and been fortunate enough to win a couple of medals, even better than that little bronze, a couple of World Cups, but more importantly those life experiences. And it was really down to making that choice and taking that personal responsibility to actually change something and actually want to do a little bit better. And I love the fact that you've done that. You're much younger than me, some of you. You know, you made that choice. And I really think that this could be a springboard to your greatest success. I went to the seaside this summer and took my daughter, I don't know if I believe I've got a daughter, and she was playing with her bucket at the old seaside, and she got these rocks, and she was putting these rocks into this big bucket. And I said, is it full? She looked back at me and it was not there. And then about 10 minutes later, I thought nothing of it, and she was already getting these pebbles, so she was putting these pebbles into them. I said, oh, is it full now? And she's like, and about 10 minutes later again, walked down to the beach, and she's already pouring sand into it. And then, I thought, it's got to be full now. And as she walked to the sea, she managed to fit even more water in it. And I always think that that is an amazing example of sometimes we think we're doing enough. We think we're at our capacity. We think we're at that 100%. And I think back to think, oh, could we do a little bit more? And I hope that you guys take this, celebrate this moment, celebrate this success, and don't let this be your 100%, because there's always a little bit of room for more. Thank you very much.
I'm last year Vice President of Willingbrook Sixth Form, and this evening I'll be giving the vote of thanks speech. Now, before I begin, I just want to confirm that my sweaty armpits from the monologue was just water, and in no way in relation to getting nervous about doing this speech. So tonight I'll be giving the honour of thanking our guest speaker, Tom Davis, the former judo Commonwealth champion. Now, when I was asked to write a speech for a sporting champion, I thought long and hard about what to say for two reasons. One, to ensure I give Tom justice for all of his amazing achievements throughout his career. And two, to ensure I don't offend him or say anything against him, given his size. But just in case I do say Tom, I just want to remind you that Mr. Rugby has no tolerance for fighting or wrestling or judo. So I'd just like to thank Tom for all of his commitment and dedication to helping the people of Willingbrook School. And I'd also like to thank him for taking the time out to come down this evening and give such an inspirational speech, especially as his partner is close to giving birth to their third child. I know you wouldn't believe it. So I'd just like to finish off by picking up on what Tom was saying, our school motto, be the best you can be. And we're very lucky to have such amazing facilities at the school that enable people to be the best they can be at whatever they choose, whether it be drama, music or sport, the list continues. However, the facilities are only a small factor of this goal. If it wasn't for the hard work and dedication of students, staff and people like Tom, none of this would be possible. So finally, I just want to thank all the students, staff and parents for attending and wish you a safe journey home. We've got a small token and packet. It's not a medal, but it's a small token.